तजव पिता प्रहलाद, प्रहलाद लेफ्ट हिज फादर। भरत मैया विभीषण बंधु रावण हिज ब्रदर, भरत हिज मदर, गोपीज पाटे गोपीज दे लेफ्ट देयर हस्बैंड, बलि महाराज हिज गुरु एंड इट बिकेम ऑस्पिशियस फॉर देम। सो आई विल नॉट टेल यू मदर, शी रिटर्न बैक एंड व्हेन राम केम आफ्टर 14 इयर्स रिटर्न टू बैक टू अयोध्या, ही वेंट टू मदर कैकेयी, शी वाज वीपिंग बिटरली। देन ही सॉ दैट ऑल आर हियर बट भरत इज नॉट हियर, व्हाई ही नेवर केम टू हर मदर हिज मदर। So he called, Bharat came, oh go, tell her mother, my mother, your mother, all whole world she is mother, and beg pardon to her lotus feet. Then he, for the sake of Ram, he did pranam and told mother, otherwise never. So we should also, those who are in an animal cut, criticizing Guru, Vaishnava, Krishna, Bhagavan, they are all enemies of enemies. We should not have any connection with them, never and never, otherwise bhakti will go away. And thus, Ramchandra, to obey his father's order, those his father was never wanted this, but by especially Kaikeyi, he went to for 14 years, and he did miracles, so many things, and in the end, in Dandakaran, Sita was stolen by Rama, and Hanuman discovered. Hanuman crossed the ocean, one jump. And discovered, and from here there he came and told Ram, and Ram with Sugriv and Jamant, Nal, Neel, Angad, he went and made a breeze over sea, and then he destroyed whole Lanka with Ravan and Kumbhakaran, Meghnad, and he returned back there. After that, Lokushkan. So you will see something here. So who is Ram? Krishna. To establish in Marjana. How he is obedient to his father, mother. How he behaves his brothers. You should see, there was a football. Against party and one part, and they are fighting with football. One is kicking and that. Bharata is other side, he is kicking, and also Ram is
kicking the kingdom.
But after some time, what became? Duryodhana and Pandava, that began to fight for that kingdom. And how now, wife and husband, son and father, sons and son, brothers are fighting for this, for nothing. Not for a kingdom, for something, prestige, even. So this is Kali Yuga. In Treta Yuga was like that. But those who do Daj Bhajan, they should be in Satya Yuga always. If you are chanting, remembering and serving Gurudev and Krishna, then Kali Yuga cannot dare to come to you. So chant and worship Krishna, remember Krishna, Kali Yuga will be very, very far away from you. Don't quarrel for money, prestige, don't criticize each other. If you are following all these things, giving respect to seniors, and seniors also have love and affection for juniors. What Rupa Goswami has told, that is no, we should try to behave like this. If you cannot, then your coming and hearing is nothing. This world is nashwar.
Perishable.
No? This body, wealth, reputation, anything cannot go with you. They cannot please you. You should understand. And like a donkey, monkey, hog, pigs, you have tested this grihastha dharma. Don't be attached. Anyhow, be careful. If you are householder now, from householder you should do bhajan. And those who are not married, be very careful. Don't take this snake poison in your ear. Don't. And especially brahmachari and sannyasi. You should be always like that. Never and never. So in Srimad Bhagavat, you see so many character of so many kings, Valifar Bhairavya, Puranjan Upakhyan, best, Chitraketu Upakhyan, so many things. So, we should try to be in Satya Yoga and chant and remember. Give always respect for. Oh, you should have a cloth. Understand, cloth is this. Try to cover others any loop and go. No? Don't take his cloth and make naked. Means what?
Don't see the faults in others.
Huh? Don't see any fault in any other. Don't, never and never. Otherwise Krishna cannot excuse you. So this should come in your heart and do bhajan. Only bhajan, one pointed. Criticize only your mind, uncontrolled mind. He is enemy and the other side he is friend. Controlled mind is friend and uncontrolled mind is what? So, there was a king. Huh? खुद 5 मिनट तो बोलो रे बेटा ये ना एक तो कुछ बोलते थे करें ओ देन ही बिगन टू टेल आफ्टर रामचरित्र ही टोल देयर वाज अ किंग ओ ही वाज एम्परर ऑफ होल वर्ल्ड ही हैड 1 crore ऑफ वाइव्स But no son, no child. He was very much lamenting for son. One day, Angirya came, Maharshi Angirya. He saw that king is not happy. He told him, oh, you have crores of wives. Oh, I think that your khajana,
treasure
is full of jewels and everything. You are very beautiful, young. Your wives are very beautiful, young. But heart, why you are painting? He told that everything I have that you are telling, but I have no son. Please give me one son. You are very powerful. He told anyone cannot be happy by son or daughter or anything. You should try to do bhajan of Krishna. Then you can be happy. He gave so many quotations of Shastra. But he could not be satisfied. He said, I only want one son. Oh. Then he gave something. Shuru. Parimane Jagyavashesh. Sacrifice. And he told that the queen who is most dear to you, you should be. And he gave Krita Dyuti, mother, and told that you should take it. And he should take and very beautiful. Sun came. Gradually he was
growing,
grown like Chandra,
moon.
The color like moon. And he was so beautiful, charming, that even king, he left his
other queens.
Managing and everything, he gave it to priests and sadhus, and he was always sitting with
son.
Gradually he became of 5 years old. Now he was so beautiful. Mother, father, very lovely. And the queen said, one crows, they thought, now king is not even asking for a show, for clothes, for anything, she become jealous. And one day they gave some poison in milk. And at once sun died. All began to weep. Queen came and saw that his son is dying. And he was crying and became senseless. Kings heard this and he also came. And when he saw, he also fainted. In the meantime, Angira Rishi with Narada Rishi, he came and saw that no one is to give consolation to them. Then he told, why you are weeping? Who was you, yours? What relation? Now he died, what relation is now? And why you are not embracing? He is still in your house. Then they told that, oh, he is dead. Oh, what dead?
He is gone.
So, for soul you are weeping? Because soul is not there? Yes. Then, so, have you seen what was the relation you are with that? He was black or he was golden color? He was a small or he was so big, tall? He could not answer, king. And then, Narada told, oh boy, why you are not speaking? He did that at once. Miracle. Isha sat down. He told, your father and mother are crying for you, weeping. He told that, oh, I have gone in so many pieces of life, lakhs and lakhs. I don't remember in what pieces of life, while he was my father, I have also become his father, mother. Why weeping? Oh, you should come to your father. Oh. Now I have some favorable chance to do bhajan. I cannot give up. I don't want to come in the womb of any mother. I want to do bhajan in his life and to liberate and to have Krishna pray. Then told Narada Chitrakeet, oh, do you want? No, my moh has been gone. Illusion has. And then he gave mantra, and then he was liberated. But anyhow, he became Vritasura and was killed by him.
So be this. So we will tell. Go, Prema. What is this? Oh, Gaurangara Doti Pad.
Gaurange do tuti pada jan dhama sampada
Gaurange
Goswami began to tell Parikshit Maharaj, Sut Goswami to Saunakadi, and Sanat Sanandan to Narad. That even anyone can be Brahma Rishi, Brahmarshi, you know. He can go to Brahmalok here and there. Very powerful, majestic powers. Ashtasiddhi, Navnidhi, even. But he cannot be equal to any smallest bhakta of Krishna, if he is sincere. So Durvasa like this, very powerful, majestic powers. He can give cause to anyone. And on the other hand, Ambarish Maharaj. Can you tell? All should be ready, one charitra.
Jnanam jala shalakaya chakshu nilitam jena tasme shri guru nama. So Srila Gurudev has asked me to speak something of Ambarish Maharaj, Ambarish Charita, in his pastimes in Srimad Bhagavatam. So Ambarish Maharaj, he was in Madhuban and he was performing Ekadasi Vrat. And at the time of when it was ready to break his fast, he had a visitor, Durvasa Rishi, came to visit with Ambarish Maharaj. And Ambarish Maharaj, he naturally invited him to honor Mahaprasad with him. So Durvasa said that he must first of all take his bath in Jamuna, and then he would come afterwards. So Durvasa was a very powerful Brahma Rishi, and he had so many mystic powers, and he was meditating in the Jamuna, saying his Gayatri mantras for a long time. And Ambarish Maharaj, meanwhile, was waiting to honor his Paran. And the time came for breaking, which was the most important part of his brata. And without breaking at exactly the right, correct time, then his whole brata would have been wasted. So he had waited for 1 year to actually break this Paran, his Akadasi brata. So he became very worried how to what he should do, because Durvasa was being so long in returning from his bath. And he consulted with the Brahmanas what he should do, and they gave various suggestions. And finally Ambarish Maharaj, he decided himself that he would take water, or Charanamrita, and this would be considered neither breaking his fast, nor would it be considered eating. So he would not be transgressing the etiquette of dishonoring Durvasa by taking something before his guest. So he took 3 drops of Charanamrita. And at that very moment, Durvasa, in his meditation, realized what Ambarish Maharaj had done. And he became very furious. And he returned very quickly to that, to Durvasa Rishi's palace. And we see how the pride of someone like Durvasa, and compared to the humility of Ambarish, that Durvasa, he became incensed in anger. So he demanded Ambarish that, why have you broken your fast? Why have you dishonored a guest? This is etiquette in India, that no one would ever offer someone to come and take Mahaprasad, and then they would take first before them. So the Ravasa, in his fury, he pulled out one of his locks, his jata, and he threw it on the ground, and a great fiery demoness came, Krita, and she began to stalk towards Ambarish in with a huge fiery aura. And Ambarish, in his humility, he was simply meditating on the lotus feet of his beloved Sri Krishna. And he was showing no fear whatsoever as this huge fiery demon walked towards him. And at that time, Krishna could understand all that had transpired and immediately sent Sudarshan Chakra to burn that demon to pieces. And when the demon had been burnt, the chakra immediately turned to chase Durvasa. And at that time, we see the difference between a yogi and a bhakta. The bhakta is always surrendered to Krishna. And even when great fear and danger was approaching, he was immovable in his meditation on Sri Krishna. Whereas the yogi immediately turned and ran from the Sudarshan Chakra. So Durvasa, he ran all over the universes, all over the lower planetary systems and the higher planetary systems, in fear of Sudarshan Chakra. And he approached Lord Shivji himself and asked, can he please relieve him of this Sudarshan Chakra? Lord Shivji said, no, this is beyond my control. He approached Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma said, no, this is beyond my control. You must approach Narayan. So finally, he approached Lord Narayan, and Narayan said, I cannot even stop this Sudarshan Chakra. You must go and beg forgiveness from Ambarish Maharaj for the offense you have committed. So Durvasa, he was questioning Lord Narayan at that time, that why he should, what had not Ambarish Maharaj also committed some offense? And Lord Narayan was explaining that there was no offense on the part of Ambarish Maharaj, because he was honoring Bhakti Devi more than he was honoring his guest. So this is very important to understand, that the priority of honoring Bhakti Devi is most important. So then Durvasa, he returned to Ambarish Maharaj's palace and begged humbly for forgiveness from Ambarish Maharaj. And at that time, Ambarish Maharaj, he'd been waiting for a whole year while Durvasa had been running all through the universes. And he was very forgiving as soon as Durvasa arrived. And being a humble bhakta, he felt no offense had been offered to him. So he immediately embraced Durvasa and lifted him up. And Durvasa was very much affectionate at that time to Ambarish. But we see, even though Durvasa was a great offender to the Vaishnava, but still we see in the history of Durvasa Rishi so many supporting moods towards Krishna's bhaktas, because the whole time that he was running around the universes, all the other people in the universes were questioning, why is this great Rishi running in fear of his life from the Sudarshan Chakra? What has he done? And of course, everyone would understand at that time that he had offended the great devotee Ambarish. So all were singing Ambarish Maharaj's glories. So in this way, indirectly, Durvasa was actually glorifying Ambarish. Just as Durvasa, he glorified so many, like in Krishna Lila, when he gave the benediction to Radharani, that anything that she cooked would taste like nectar and increase one's life, etc. So for this reason, Mother Yashoda could always call Radharani to Nandagaon to cook for Krishna every morning. So There are many pastimes of Durvasa, but eventually Durvasa is always actually honoring the devotees. But there are many siddhants and tapas within this pastime.
Thank
you. Shri Gurudev will explain.
You should prepare more. Prepare more. So here there is a teaching that Krishna Bhakta, who are Ekantik Krishna Bhakta, they don't afraid of even death. He was just standing. He was not fearful. What should be done? Krishna is doing okay. So when Kritya was coming, fire, and he was only what doing? He was remembering Krishna. And Durvasa fled away. When Chakshudarshan followed, he fled. And if that Sudarshan was persuading him for 1 year, but why not cutting, finishing? Because Ambarish Maharaj was praying that, oh Sudarshan Chakra, you should not kill. But he, Sudarshan also waiting that when he will come, apologize to Ambarish, then I will kill. Otherwise not. So he was moving. And he was fine. So any bhakta should not be worry for anything. If some suffering coming, you should talk it. If sukh is coming, oh, after that, maybe again suffering may come. So you should be ready for that and do bhajan like Ambarish Maharaj. Then he told about Sagar and Ganga Avataranam and Ikshvaku Vansa and then Dagni Parshuram, Jajati and last Jadu Bansh, Jadu. Jadu kept kingdom for Krishna. So Krishna came in the Jadu Bansh. Now we will begin Krishna Charitra Dashamishkandha.
निवृत्ततर्षैरुपगीयमाना बहुसदश्रोत्रीमनोभिराम कः उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् कुमान विरज्येत बिना पशुना
निवृत्ततर्षै डिटैच्ड लाइक सुखदेव गोस्वामी महाराज परीक्षित जी टेलिंग After Nama Skandha. Oh, he told them, can you take water or anything? Oh, no need. I'm hearing your sweet pastimes of Krishna. Nibhata Tarasing, a person who is detached from worldly things. His Rasik Bhav also. His Tattata Guru. And what he is telling, he is speaking sweet pastimes of Krishna. This is Bhausadha. This is the Rambaan, Achuk.
Infallible medicine for
Bhavaroga. I have told to you. Punar punar.
Jananam
punarapi maranam punarapi janani jathalila. Janam, birth, death. Again, birth, death. From beginning of Brahma creation, this Brahmanda creation. But we are coming. Now, Krishna has given mercifully this human form. So, for this rogue, only Rambaan Aushadhi is Krishna Katha. No Gyan, no Vairagya, nothing. Anyone cannot save him. Only hearing Harikatha from a realized person like Sukadeva Goswami or in his life. Then this is Aushadhi. And what? Shrotri Manopirama. And for other persons, what? In hearing so sweet, and if realizing that Harikatha, then what to tell? So both is. For others also. Kah uttam shlok gunanubad. So, in this world, who have no taste to hear Harikatha, so many devotees comes at the time of hearing Katha. If even they go to Parikrama of Navadvip Vrindavan, they are not good. They are like killer of their soul and others too. Where there is Harikatha, like Sukhdev Goswami, anyone, Rasik Vaishnava, we must hear here, giving up all duties and everything. And then he began to tell. And he became Sukhdev Goswami. He told that I don't need water. For water this my this stage came. No water, nothing. Water is your Harikatha. So you should go on. Eum nisham bhrigunandan sadhubadam vayyasaki sa bhagavanath vishnuratam pratyach krishna charitam kali kalmasagnam vyahartam marvata bhava. Then he began to speak. How Krishna came in the womb of Mother Devaki. How Krishna came in the womb of Mother Yashoda. How Brahma told all the demigods and his wives to come to serve Krishna and also Tatpriya, Radhika. For them they should go and they should take birth in the dynasty of Jadu or Nand Maharaj, Parjanyabho. So all were like that. And somewhere the associates of Krishna, directly from Golok Vrindavan, also demigods and their wives, became Gop, Gopi, Jadu, Bansi, Jado, and so many. Like in Ram Leela, when Ram came, his so many, Hanuman and Sugriva and all other came from his Saket Dham, and some demigods, oh, they also became monkeys and bears and so many things. And they served and helped Ram. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came from all round, from everywhere. So many devotees came from Golok Vrindavan, from Navadvip, Shvetdvip, from Narayan Lok, Jai Vijay came in Jagai Madhai. Hanuman came in Murari Gupta form. So many. Shivas, Naradvas Shivas, like Madhumanga. So all came. And then this Lisa was so beautiful and warm. Raramananda, he was Lalita, Ishakha. And Sarup Damodar, himself, Lalita. So many comes. So time to time it comes like this. So
then how Putana came and what became? Can you? Where is Damodar? Without here, you speak. Ladies, anyone can speak? Except Shyamran. You should all try to be careful, qualified to speak something and preach my mission. In brief.
That's my
more louder.
And how do you ask me to speak? Put on that time.
Speak like me?
Putana of the came was sent by Kamsa because Kamsa knew that the Lord Krishna has appeared in Nandagram and wanted to kill all the babies. On the newborn babies. So, as Gurudev was described the other day, how putana meaning one with no good qualities, and also who can no kids, no children. And she has the
no son, putana. Though she is not pure.
No pure.
Always drinking blood of wild, taking him like eggs. So fearful. Always a puppet.
She is, no good qualities, always impure. So she was very much qualified in that sense. And Kamsa was very happy to send her to annihilate all the babies. And when she went in the disguise of her mother, and because she also no children, she didn't have any breast milk, so she smeared with the poison. And then when she approached Krishna, Krishna accepted and then she sucked her life. Even though she went with the intention of killing her, Krishna was so merciful. He gave her the position of a nursing mother. So that is the mercy of Krishna. Like Gurudev was telling the morning walk today, let's give one question. How the difference between the mercy of Krishna that showed to Mother Putana, that he gave that wonderful nursing mother situation compared to Chandrika and Spectra, who wanted to kill him. Of course, they were not disguised. So that shows the mercy of the Guru also, that if we approach sincerely, we could bestow that invaluable Krishna prema to all of us.
Thank you. Yes, should speak something. Aho vakiyam stanakalukut.
Try to speak like them, very bravely. I thought that you will fall down, but by the mercy of Krishna, you could.
Guru,
no, all should be.
Om agyana timiram dasya, jnanam janashalakaya, chakshuram meditam yena, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So, this story of Putana coming to attempt to kill baby Krishna is very illustrative of one very important quality of Sri Krishna. He is unlimitedly merciful. How can we understand from this pastime how merciful Krishna is? Actually, Uddhava ji, he pointed this out. This was later on, after Krishna had wound up his pastimes in this world, and he was wandering here and there, everywhere, completely in the mood of separation from Krishna. And at that time, by the will of the Lord, Vidura came and met Uddhava and inquired from him about Krishna. And Uddhava, in his intense mood of separation, he began to remember all of Krishna's pastimes that he had performed while he was present on this earth. And then he spoke this verse, Aho bakiyam stanakalakuta jigyam sayor papayayan apyasadvi gate kambadayalur sharanam brajem. So here he's asking the question, oh, this putana, this rakshashi, this very horrible, wicked witch, as Gurudev said, who like to drink the blood of so many babies and kill them mercilessly, she came with the intention to actually kill Krishna. She smeared poison on her breast and she forcibly entered into the nursing room of baby Krishna, who was only a few weeks old. And she took on this form. This demoness was able to transform her form and become very, very beautiful. So strikingly beautiful that even all of the Brijvasis thought she must be some demigoddess who has come. So in this way, she came in a very deceptive way. And she attempted to kill baby Krishna. And when Krishna saw her entering into the room, oh, he closed his eyes. But she forcibly took her breast nipple and forced it into his mouth, smeared with poison in order to kill Krishna. But what did Krishna do? Oh, he began to suck on her breast, just as a child will suck on the breast of a mother. And he took her motherly approach. Not that she was a demoness. Of course, he also dealt with her as a demoness because he sucked out her very life force. And as this was happening, Putana became so much startled and she began to scream and she tried to pull baby Krishna off of her breast and she ran out into the courtyard. But even though Putana was as strong and stronger than 10,000 elephants, she had this power, but she could not pull baby Krishna off of her breast. And then her actual form transformed into this huge demoness going up into the sky. She was huge and gigantic. It's described in 10th canto that she was practically like 10 miles, 12 miles long in height. And she came crashing to the ground. So little baby Krishna, who was playing there on her breast, was simply taking her as mother. And Mother Yashoda, in the meantime, and all the Brijvasis, when they saw this happen, they began to scream out in terror, oh, where is my son, my son? And Mother Yashoda came running, and she simply found baby Krishna playing like a huge hill. He was playing there on the breast of Putana. But what was the actual result that Putana gained from her attempt to kill Krishna? Oh, Krishna didn't accept that she had come to kill him. What he accepted was her motherly affection, that she took the position of mother. And in this way, when he killed her, he awarded her the position of Tatri, nursemaid, in Goloka Vrindavan. So when Uddhava was remembering this pastime, he said, Kamvadayalur Sharanam Brajema. Who can I possibly ever take shelter of any other Lord who could be so merciful as this Krishna,
who gave the position, awarded the eternal service and eternal position of mother to someone who had come to kill him. So I cannot take shelter of anyone else. He is so merciful, so merciful. And in this way, Uddhava began weeping and weeping.
What is the meaning of Dhatri Uchit Gati?
That means that she attained the position of nursemaid, like mother. Not exactly directly that she became mother, but she attained the position of nursemaid, that sometimes
Dhatri means not mother. Dhatri means not mother. So, not like mother. Like?
Life nursemaid.
Yes. Giving.
Even not Dhatri.
Even not nursemaid. Like.
Like. Not like Dhatri. Like that. So, where she went? What is Gati? What Gati? Where she went?
In the Loka Vrindavan.
What doing? Thank you. Why he gave Krishna Dhatri Uchit Gati? She made the form of a mother. Oh, lovely son, oh, lovely son. Very affectionate mood. She wanted to kill, but from words, oh, my Lala. Lala, Lala. Lala means?
Darling son.
Darling son.
Come on. And he forcibly gave. So this Lala word and that form made Krishna very satisfied. And he gave it to Dhatri Uchit Gati. Not Dhatri even.
Like that.
So, if anyone has some affection, Brahma is telling, he was in confusion that if he has given enemy like Putana, Dhatri Uchit Gati. Then what he will give it to Brajavasi to have really motherly love, and they gave breast and milk to Krishna. And what of the cows? For 1 year they gave Krishna. So what he will give? And moreover, what he will give it to gopis? Oh, he was in confusion. And really it is. Krishna may tell that I cannot repay you, only this. He cannot give anything more than that. So, the charitra we should try to realize. And then, what became? His body was so fragrant, it was cut to pieces. And when fire was given, fragrant came everywhere. Why? Because Krishna touched. And then Nanda Baba was coming from Mathura. He found some fragrance. And then then he came to Vrindavan Gokul. And he was so attached that I will never go like this anywhere. Always protect. But one question is that, you see, Vrindavan is very pure. Any demigods cannot go there. But how a demon like Putana went, Agasur, Bakasur, all went there? Why? They have not done any austerities, anything. They were brought by Yog Maya to increase the love and affection and to renew the love and affection of gopis, Braj gopis to Krishna. That is why. Otherwise, any demon cannot go there. And then, Shakatabhanga. Shakatabhanga. You know? Shaktasu. If you not know, then you? You know Shaktasu? What is the meaning of Shakar?
Cart.
Okay, what?
Cart.
Yes. God.
So Srila Gurudev just was telling that in order to renew the love of the inhabitants of Vrindavan, so Yogamaya, once in a while, in such a circumstance, she allowed one demons to enter and to play a part in Krishna's pastimes. So in the case of Shakatasura, this is exactly what happened. Because Krishna was put in a cart nearby everyone, and everyone was enjoying a festival of Krishna's birthday, I guess. I'm not sure, but there was a big festival. Yes?
Under the cart.
Oh.
90 days.
Okay. That festival. So. So. Yes.
No way. Better you should sit down.
No, I don't understand.
Quickly, shaman is going. Time is going.
So, all the residents were enjoying dancing and taking prasadam and everything. And for a little while, they forgot Krishna. Krishna was left alone on that cart.
Under the cart.
There was also levels on that cart. So, at that time, Shakatasura came in Vrindavan. He came without body because he remembered that previously all those who came with body, they got killed. So he thought, if I come without body, just like a spirit, then nobody will know that I have come in Vrindavan. So he entered Vrindavan in that state of completely invisibility. So he approached Krishna, and looking at the situation, he saw that there was many pots and bags of rice and many things that could help him to kill Krishna. And the way he wanted to kill Krishna is to put all these things on top of the cart. And by the weight of all these things, the top level will crush and completely finish Krishna. And on top of this, he would put himself just to wait more on that cart, and definitely he will kill Krishna. So, Krishna saw him as a sannyasi, because he was devoid of bodily conception. He came without body. So Krishna thought, oh, he wants to offer me all these things, so I accept the offering. But the way he did offer these things was not properly done, because his mood motivation was not proper. He wanted to kill Krishna, just like Charu and Mustik. So they're not belonging to that verse, Anyavajisutasunya. So Krishna, seeing this, he kicked all the offerings with his foot on the cart. And all the offerings and Shakatasura on top of those offerings, they went in the air. And in this offering, there was oil, there was chili.
What? Not offering. Nand Baba has kept
milk products.
Oh, products of milk and curd and so many things on that cart. But Krishna touched when that cart, and the cart was